Hi, it's Larry Hryb, Xbox's Major Nelson. Welcome to the official Xbox podcast. Here we are rolling into, well, in the Northern Hemisphere, summer, wherever you are, maybe in the Southern Hemisphere, it's winter. You know, we just had the longest day of the year, gang. Hello, Rebecca. Hello, Jeff.
So long.
Yeah.
So long.
It's all downhill from here.
Well, no. Or if you're, you know, under the equator, the bottom half of the globe, it's the shortest day of the year and it's uphill.
I got the most emails on that day of any day so far in 2023, if that's this year.
Is that what the system has told
Daylight
you?
Daylight emails. That's how I measure it.
Yeah, I see.
I don't know how everyone else does it.
All right. Well, anyway, welcome back to the show. Welcome back, Rebecca. Welcome back, Jeff. It's nice to have you guys back in. Talk about what we're playing this week, some of the news of the week. We got some, we're going to talk about some hardware stuff later on.
No gloves, though.
Yeah.
Rattle the hardware, Larry.
I've got the gloves because not only are we going to talk about, you know, this stuff, see how I'm wrapping them in the gloves, but we're also going to talk about some other piece of hardware, too, that Jeff's got some notes on. So we'll talk about that. But anyway, video games. That's why we're here. We like them. We make them. We play them even. So let's, Rebecca, what have you been playing this week?
Sure. So there's some good stuff that's come out on Game Pass recently.
Yeah.
I just started playing, I'm going to butcher it's a French title. It's called Dordogne.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm going to check this out. Tell us about it.
Yeah. I finished Planet of Lana, which yep. I think I had also described as kind of like a watercolor.
Yeah, we had some video last week of you playing.
Yeah. So Planet of Lana, great game. Pretty short, good story for a game with like no real dialogue. But yeah, that was awesome. But then this game, Dordogne, has like much more of a watercolor feel.
Even more?
Also. Yeah.
Wow. Okay.
And it kind of seems like it bounces between 2D and 3D sometimes, which is a really interesting art style. So that's kind of what drew me in. And then I watched the trailer and the gameplay is fairly simple. I would say it's more focused on the story. So you're kind of living through this character Mimi and getting flashbacks of her like summer in France with her, I think it's her grandmother. But yeah, so the gameplay is fairly simple. It's kind of helping Mimi, you know, do like simple puzzles and actions, but the story looks really nice. And then obviously it's a really gorgeous game. So yeah, I just picked that one up and I will be playing this weekend. And then the other
I'm looking one, for it now, by the way. I'm listening to you. I'm just looking for it.
I know. I don't have it up on the TV. Sorry. I also only have like a third of my TV that's visible. So it doesn't really have the same effect as with you guys. Have you guys ever, I know.
There it is.
You want to see this corner of what I'm playing? Have you guys ever played Stacking? It's an older title, but it just came
yes.
to Xbox Game Pass.
I actually have something to show you.
I know what you've got, Larry.
Yeah, hold on. I'll let you talk. Now, by the way, I want to talk about something, gentlemen and ladies. Yeah. Last week, when we were doing the show, I can't remember. I had to go off mic for a little bit and go to my kitchen and get the peppers.
I don't recall any of this.
Yeah, and there was quite a saucy conversation going on in my absence. When I was editing the show, I was like, oh, I see what goes on when I take my headphones off. Go back and listen. You'll see it.
Anyway, maybe be prepared.
Keep it short because I'm only going to be off for about 3 seconds.
All right.
Okay. But yes,
that's a nice shirt.
Me too.
What do you think? I thought it was
Psychonauts.
Great.
Psychonauts.
Yeah. Tell us about the Stacking, because this is a game that I was really into when it first came out on the 360.
I haven't played it, but it just came to Xbox Game Pass, so I have it downloaded. But I saw some of the screenshots, I read about it. It seems pretty cool, and obviously Double Fine makes some amazing games, and I was hoping you guys could either give it a seal of approval or tell me to go elsewhere, and it sounds like it has the seal of approval. Oh, boy.
Yes.
Oh,
so,
do you have one of the dolls?
So not only do I have one of the dolls, because it's Stacking.
Yeah.
I have them all.
Oh, so cool.
So this was actually a gift when Double Fine. This is actually before we owned them.
I mean, it's the perfect merch for the
game. Oh yeah,
this is
like 2010, 2011, I want to say.
And so I remember getting this from Tim Schafer. And it's you and Rebecca, you and I work on a lot of video games. Rebecca, you spend so much time on Minecraft, and Jeff on a bunch of different games. And once in a while, we get these interesting little gifts and tchotchkes. Should we call them tchotchkes, Jeff?
Let's do it, Larry.
Okay. Right?
You're approved.
Yeah.
But we get some, and I have a whole bunch over here that I should put on display of really meaningful things. And this is something that I've had for, you know, 10, 12 years. Actually, my daughter plays with it now. She loves it because it's all these little dolls. So anyway, there's a game out right now, to your point, Rebecca, called Stacking on Game Pass from Double Fine, where it's puzzles with stacking the individual dolls in here. So it's, or not in here, but in the game.
And the different characters, anytime you encounter another one of those dolls, you can take control of them and they all have different abilities. So some are really small and they can go, and I just recall like going through like a steamship. I think it took place like, you know, early 1900s, something like that, and had a really cool feel to it. I should go back to that. It's been a long time.
I have fuzzy memories of that one. So, Larry, I'm so surprised that you still have these dolls. I mean,
it
was 2011.
I'm going to give you guys a little insight here. You listeners, I think Jeff and Rebecca know this. So as I said earlier, we get access to a lot of really great things, and we're fortunate to work in this industry. And every once in a while, we'll get some things from the industry like these beautiful stacking dolls that I can tell there was thought and care and real meaning behind what this is. It wasn't just a, hey, let's take a t-shirt and slap a logo on it. I got a zillion of those. Anybody can slap a logo on a t-shirt.
So true.
But this is all about the game. Hey, Jeff, I'm not talking about you.
This is embroidered, by the way. There's no slapping involved.
Right. But what I'm saying is it's not just, and there's actually, I will tell this other story, is I have this running joke with one of our partners here at Microsoft. You know who it is, Helber.
Yeah.
Hello. Is that Pumbaa?
Yeah.
Wow. He's really bringing his A game today. But anyway, I have this relationship with one of our partners here at Microsoft that makes things for us, a lot of the merchandise and different things. And I always tell them, don't bother me with stuff that I can see anybody's logo on. I want to see something bespoke. So to answer your question, Rebecca, there's certain things that come along in my game that I have up there that I know are incredibly meaningful, that there was a lot of thought and design in there. Frankly, they're original. So so I've got a whole bunch of stuff. I should really merch it. I mean, this is just some of it. I've got a bunch of stuff in the garage as well. I should really merchandise it up. So anyway, enough about me. Stacking on Game Pass.
I agree. Yeah. I think I had to throw away some mugs when I moved recently because like I get a lot of mugs, you get a lot of glasses, you get a lot of t-shirts, but that kind of unique item you hold on to, I guess. But I'd be curious what's the oldest like merch item that Larry has.
Like, here's a great example.
He's got a hoop that you hit with a stick.
This is
original game. No, I asked what the oldest
the original video game.
Like merch item that you have is.
Probably something from Halo 2.
Oh, yeah.
I think I have a bag from Halo 2 upstairs, but this is, and it's a little dusty because it's, but this is from 2016. Before Sea of Thieves even launched, we sold these at San Diego Comic-Con 2016.
Glow in the Dark.
That's and he glows cool. in the dark. This is one of the characters. And this is before anybody ever played the game. And I was like, this is pretty amazing. So I've got a bunch of little things like that up, you know, in here.
Well, what I like is that so much of these things are now on the gear store. It used to be something that if you didn't work in the industry, you weren't going to be able to get it. And now you go to gear.xbox.com. The shirt that I'm wearing, which I wore at our showcase and got so many compliments on it, definitely, you know, inflated my ego a little bit.
Do they ask you which way to the beach? Again.
I've been wearing it every day since. But yeah, there's a really cool, like bright color collection, but they do a lot of those things, pint glasses and
actually we've had them on the show before, James and the team from who run the gear shop. And it's exactly right. They don't want to just take stuff and slap a logo on it and kick it out there. Like you'd get really at a trade nice show. They want to do stuff that's high quality, that's distinctive. And wow, there's some really cool stuff up here. I haven't been over here in a while. Anyway, so that's the story behind. We're getting back to stacking and Game Pass. So
yeah. Let's see. Yep. But that's what I've been playing. What I'm going to play. What about you guys?
Good question. Let's see. Halo kicked off their new season earlier this week, so I've been playing some Infection. Diablo.
Ooh, Infection.
Infection is back, and they have a new ability or a new tool in there, which is kind of cool. It's kind of like Zomber, where she can warp back to a point, Jeff. It's kind of like that. So you can do that. Been playing that. It's available now. And so go download that. And there's a new season. There's a whole bunch of new stuff. There's a new core, which is what you put the armor on. So a bunch of new stuff about that. I'm working my way through Diablo. Which is great because I go back and forth between, I can't show it, but I go back and forth between my console and my PC. Because there's cross play and cross progression. So I just sign in over here. Sometimes I'm playing during the day. Sometimes I play over here, and it's great to be able to go back and forth like that. So
if we were to go back 10 years and be like, oh yeah, any device you're on, like your progression is going to carry over. And that's become effectively the norm for games. It's a good place to be because it didn't always.
Well, do you remember how it started? Do you remember how it started is that I remember when we shipped this feature, and I think it was before they shipped the feature, definitely before Nintendo and certainly before PlayStation, which is where you could sync up game saves to the cloud.
Oh yeah.
And that's something that, like, right now, of course your stuff lives in the cloud. My game saves are there, but before you had to like have a memory unit, run around and copy it. And anyway, so but this is, to your point, Jeff, cross play and cross progression is kind of an evolution of that.
Yeah. It never ceases to feel like magic. I was in Vancouver, Canada a couple of weeks ago, and my cousins there had an Xbox Series S, and I was in the middle of Planet of Lana, and I was like, well, I'll come back to it next weekend. And then when I saw it there, I was like, all the bits are there, and ended up finishing the game up there.
Sync done. It was awesome. So yeah.
It was great. So left it on there.
I'm playing Diablo, playing Halo. What else am I playing in? I did a little, there's a new season of Apex and Overwatch is coming along too. So I got to get into that. So that's kind of what I've been working on. We've got a lot
of
work.
You are the shooter mans. Yes.
I guess I am. I mean, you know me, I love my puzzlers as well. So, and I need to, I think, Rebecca, you've inspired me. I think I may go back to stacking, and I'll sit with my dolls in my lap while I'm playing it. So just to really commune with them. Jeff, what about you? What's got your fancy? Usually I have to go full screen on you because you want to use the visual.
Oh, aids. It's fine. It's good. So
what's with the old, by the way, you know what that's called over your left shoulder?
What?
Do you know what we used to call those?
The rings?
Yeah. We used to call them the rings of light.
The rings.
That was the marketing term for those all the different little rings in Xbox 360. So
I am bathing in the glow of the rings of light. I still like all those various shades of green. So, and yellow, I suppose.
Yeah.
So I'm in that mode, or I came back from our showcase a week and change ago. And every time we would have like E3 back in the day or a group of, you know, showcases, Gamescom, you have that feeling like, I only want to play games that aren't out yet. Because you get so excited for things that are out. And I was very excited for Star Wars Outlaws. And I realized, I never finished Star Wars Jedi Survivor. I kind of had bounced off of it. I played like 5 hours of it. And then Diablo came out. And I think it was busy. And then I just forgot about it. So I went back into it. And I think it was you, Larry, who gave me good advice, the game starts to open up on this planet when you arrive at the planet, and you call Kobo, and you establish sort of a base there. And you told me, get the heck off of Kobo as quick as possible.
Yeah.
And just really get the story rolling. Yep. And I was just wandering around, and I kind of lost my way a little bit. And so when I loaded the game back up, I just made a beeline for the ship, progressed the story. And you know what? This game is awesome. So as it turns out, the reviews did indicate that. But that's when it really grabbed me. And I've played nothing but for the last few days. I think by the time we hit next show, I should have finished it. But it is an excellent game. Some amazing set pieces. There's the one with Marin, Larry. Oh, man. You know what turn I'm talking about. Yep. I was like, this is so cool. So it was fun to be able to get that back. And intermittently playing Diablo as well, because that game is awesome. And same thing, jumping back and forth between playing over here and on my Asus Rogue Ally, because it works pretty well portably. So getting all the tweaking.
I need to get back. You inspired me. I need to get back to Jedi because I didn't finish it. I'm a little bit further ahead than you are.
Okay.
But one of the barriers, I guess so, is I'm like, oh God, I got to relearn it because I'm going to forget all. Because the way that good game design is you learn your skills as you're going through the game. So now I'm so far in the game where it expects me to know the skills. And after a month, I'm like, I forgot them.
I would say that the controls are pretty streamlined.
Right.
Compared to the first game. you know, you're using,
at least I won't be throwing a grenade every moment. Like, that's the classic blunder, right?
Yeah. Yeah. When you forget what button does what, you've all done that. I got back into it very quickly. I feel like the timing is reasonably generous on blocking and parrying. And if you find that it's not generous enough, you can actually tweak that, which I think is also just
story
really
mode.
Good from a, both an accessibility perspective and also, really tailoring the challenge to exactly what you want it to
yeah.
be. So
yeah.
I like that it asked me before it gives me a hint on some puzzle. I was like, no,
do
no,
you
no.
Want a hint, Jeff? Do you really want a hint?
So you get to
meanwhile, tell he's scrolling on his phone.
Yeah.
I may have done that on one of them, but that's fine. Anyway, so great game. And I'm only that much more excited for the next one when you get to play a scoundrel coming out next year.
Yeah, looking forward to that too. So did you play Jedi, Rebecca? I know we talked about it a while ago. You just haven't gotten around to that, right?
No, I haven't.
Good game.
Yeah.
GG. By the way, I didn't tell you this. When I was down in Mexico City, I did that event with a bunch of with many fans where we played Halo. And that's the way I signed everything, all the stuff that they wanted me to autograph.
Cute. It was
GG. So because we were playing together. It was a good game. So.
Yeah.
All right, what else we got here? We got some news, Jeffrey?
That we do.
Okay.
So you were talking about some games that hit Game Pass recently, but there is another batch of 7 titles that have come to Game Pass across console and PC, and most of them to cloud as well, that I will just jam through. Biggest one here, most name recognition would be Need for Speed Unbound, thanks to EA Play. This one is now in the vault. So if you're a Game Pass Ultimate or EA Play member, you can start playing Need for Speed Unbound. The vault is called the playlist. I just need to catch myself.
If you're watching this video on Spotify, where I sometimes post questions, or on YouTube, you can actually see the entire list on your screen at this moment while Jeff narrates.
I won't read all 7, but I heard some really good things about Bramble the Mountain King. So very cool that one is straight onto Game Pass. That'll be next week is when that one will be hitting. Cozy gamers might be into Story of Seasons, Friends of Mineral Town.
Yep.
And then a game that sort of caught my eye, has some really cool art there in the middle lower, which is Sword and Fairy Together Forever. This one is a RPG, an action RPG based on some Chinese mythology. It looked really cool. It actually is. It's out. There's a demo right now. It's out on Xbox. It came out in November. I missed it. A lot of games hitting, the end of the year. But on July 5th, it will be coming into Game Pass for console and PC. And you better believe I will be downloading it and checking it out. It looked fun.
I'm leaving the artwork up for you really to enjoy.
So
yeah, it looks nice.
Few games available today. Actually, you just landed right on it. So Necrom, which is the latest chapter of the Elder Scrolls Online. I got to see a really deep dive on this app update at GDC. It's a new area, but it's also a new class, the Arcanist class, which is what you're seeing right there. Has some really cool abilities. You're back into like Morrowind in some areas. So if you were a Morrowind fan back on the OG Xbox
darn
near 20 years ago, you get to revisit Morrowind, see what it looks like now. So the way it works is Elder Scrolls Online is included with Game Pass, and then there's all kinds of different updates. There was like High Isle, and there's been a ton of them.
Yeah, we had somebody on from that team from Bethesda, from ZeniMax earlier this year, so they talked about all this update.
Yeah, the developer direct.
If you got Game Pass, then you get a discount on these updates, and Necrom is looking like one of the meatiest ones yet. So
I played Morrowind on my friend's Xbox. I had one friend, Kalia, in like middle school, I think, either middle school or high school, and we played Morrowind, and I remember being like kind of terrified at the time. I wasn't into RPGs yet, but
did you tell Todd Howard that?
No, but
my brother was very into it. I wasn't, Larry, weren't you the one that when you had a conversation with Todd, something in like 2021, when you had like the four boxes here and talking about it, that the game actually, there was times where it had to reset in the background
while the loading screen was up.
Yeah, yeah.
It's basically like it's the video game equivalent of drawing the curtains while we reset the set behind the curtains.
So. Yeah, it was pushing the system that much, which is awesome. So, couple other games that are out now: Crash Team Rumble. Hearing that is a fun one to play. Always fun to see Crash Bandicoot on my Xbox. Aliens: Dark Descent. Larry, I know you're a big Aliens fan. This is a different type of game. It looks like an isometric co-op shooter, which looks pretty cool. It is available at a discounted price of $39.99.
Price to sell.
It's actually more strategic. It's being listed as a strategy game, so definitely something I'm looking. Oh yeah, so it is. It is more of a strategy game where you're guiding a fire team through of colonial marines through what I'm sure are terrifying areas filled with xenomorphs, but definitely look like my type of thing. And then Free Play Days. So if you're looking for something to play this weekend and you happen to be an Xbox Live Gold or Ultimate member, a few games available for you: Conan Exiles, Age of Sorcery. There's Manual Samuel, which I ended up, very interesting game that I tried out at GDC some years ago. And I don't think I ever went back to it. So this is one worth checking out. Very interesting game where you're like literally controlling. If you think about all the elements of your life that your body is sort of on autopilot, like breathing. Oh my God, it's only like 99 cents too.
What really are you doing?
It's sort of like co-op for your whole life. And then Football Manager 2023 for console. We know Football Manager, always one of the biggest games worldwide of the year. We're into the transfer season if you're an English football fan. And so I have been...
I'm a Ted Lasso fan. Yeah. Does that count?
That's like maybe your gateway to becoming a Premier League fan, because the story's not necessarily about soccer per se. Right. I mean, it transcends football, I guess you would say.
Sure.
They got so many of the details right. Who's coaching this team? They're actually in the stadium. This player is based on this player. Right. Jamie Tartt's kind of like this player and all this. And so, and of course, just like in real life, Man City ends up winning everything. So as usual, it is what it is. But great show.
Spoilers.
Great league. They won the FA Cup at the end of season two. What do you think I'm talking about?
Okay. Right? Okay. Spoilers. So,
that was the episode. It was really cool. The one after that. Anyway, enough of that.
Yeah.
Fun thing. Last thing, something I don't like saying things like, hey, put this on your calendar for like 3 weeks from now, because I can't remember what I'm going to be doing, having for dinner tonight.
But everybody's got one of these devices. You just tell your device, hey, remind me in 2 weeks to do this.
Then Siri or Cortana
or Alexa or
Alexa, please.
Or Google.
My phone, my house. Probably. Yeah. On July 11th, tune into the IGN Cross ID at Xbox Digital Showcase.
Yeah.
It'll be 10 a.m. Pacific time, and IGN is going to be hosting this and just revealing a ton of cool ID games. It's the annual Summer Game Demo Fest. So that will be hitting that day too. So a lot of the things that will be getting shown, you'll actually be able to download demos of. So it should be really fun, and you'll be able to play those just for a week. July 11th through the 17th.
And we'll get some of those game developers on the show to talk about their very games, because I love talking to independent developers, because usually it's two or three or four or five people, and you know they're highly passionate. Yeah. So it's a very different type of game. The scale of
indie games can be anything from one person working solo to a pretty big team, and it's just amazing the breadth, and I'm hoping some of the
creativity.
Yes, and I hope that some of the games I got to see at GDC will be there, because I got to play some really fun stuff this year. So
fun.
We'll see.
What else you got?
I'll remind you then.
You have some stuff in the notes I think you need to go over too.
Oh, yes, that's right. Sorry, I was driving through the news so fast that I nearly missed Porsche. So, Larry, is this something you have ready to go here?
Well, let me, it's going to take a second here. Oh, let's go back to me. You know, as I'm running the whole show,
we can talk about other things too, if you want to start there.
All right. This showed up. Random stuff shows up at my front door every once in a while. Well, not, it's anyway. So this is an Xbox Series X, but it's not just an Xbox Series X, gentlemen and ladies.
Love the shouting.
Hold on. Jeff, do you want to talk about? You know what I'll do? Let's roll this trailer so you can talk about it while I unbox this thing. Go ahead and tell us about the promotion.
Sure. So we are celebrating, along with Porsche, Porsche's 75th anniversary by reimagining the automaker's iconic motorsport liveries. Those are the paint jobs, if you're not a car person. These liveries are part of racing lore, like some very iconic looks, as you can see in this video. Or if you're listening, just trust us. They look really cool.
They do.
So we're taking six of Porsche's most unforgettable looks and reimagining them on the ultimate canvas, the Xbox Series X console, and accompanying controllers. So we've revealed a number of these at events. We first started showing these off, I think at Summer Games Fest, you got to see some of them. The important thing here is there's two things. One, they look awesome. Two,
you ready for this?
You have the ability to win one. Oh, wow. So let's look at that one. Very bold coloring.
This is only the white one, white Xbox Series X, I think I've ever seen.
Wow. Right?
Look at the beautiful colors.
Beautiful. Yeah.
Wait, is it white or is it multicolored and then they painted part of it white?
Well, that's a good question.
Is it white with black stripes or
right?
You know, oh, the world may never know.
And it's got a little bit of this on the background there. Now it also has a controller too. So let me show off the controller. What would it be without a controller, gang? All right, here we go. Oh yeah, and of course the matching controller. So, and I like to wear the white gloves for these because you can't buy these, but we're going to be giving Xbox is going to be giving these away.
It also makes it just far less distracting for us viewers because Larry, you're little known fact, a well known hand model, but this way by wearing those gloves, the product gets to stand out. So look, we're not showing this to you just so you can go, wow. Happy for you, Larry. It's because you can win one. So you should go to PorscheXboxSweepstakes.com from now through October 1st, and you can enter to win. And I wish you luck because we are unable to win them by law. So please win it and tell me how it is so I can live vicariously through you. PorscheXboxSweepstakes.com.
Yeah,
a couple of things to call out. And maybe the pattern sort of reminds me that we are here into the last few days of the last week, I should say, of Pride Month. And something to check out over on Xbox Wire is we did announce an ongoing partnership with GLAAD. We have all manner of celebrations for Pride, folks on twitch.tv/Xbox. We've been bringing folks from the LGBTQ+ community onto the channel and pulling some amazing numbers broadcasting for us. So we were glad to have them on the show or onto the channel, and that will continue through the week. So definitely lend your support and check out everything that we're doing there.
Yeah.
Last bit of news. Yes, Larry, please.
No, go ahead. We just do some great stuff every month. And as Jeff said, we bring in all streamers to join us streaming with Xbox. So maybe that could be you one day, whatever your area of passion is.
Yeah, we'd love to find up-and-coming streamers that can be part of the show. People who, it isn't always the like, hey, who's got the most followers? Let's put those people up there. We love to sort of share our stage with people that are creating awesome content, but maybe you know, haven't hit it big yet. If we can be a partner in your success, that makes us happy.
Yeah.
Last thing. We all love our Xbox rewards. Time you play a Game Pass
rewards
game.
Rewards for playing. What's wrong with that?
Exactly. Especially popping an achievement. And it's like, oh, you've earned this. And then you can take those points and you can go ahead and you can buy things. You can donate them to charity, which I often tend to do. Well, the one thing is sometimes they're not the easiest thing to find. Well, you know, like if you see the pop-up and you don't hold the Xbox button down immediately.
Where do I go?
Say, where does this actually live? Well, they're now easy to find with a new rewards tab. You can jump to them quickly by pressing the Xbox button, which opens the guide, choosing your profile, which is, there we go.
You know, on screen right now.
System, and you choose my rewards. And it's pretty easy to find. You probably see that all the time. You just click there. And we will be it's available now, rolling this out to everyone in any market that supports these Xbox Quests, which is folks in the US, Canada, Mexico, Brazil, UK, many, many other places. So worth checking out. If you haven't looked in a while, you may be surprised that you have thousands of points, which you can use, again, to either donate to charity or you can buy yourself more Game Pass or put it towards something else. It does.
Do you have unclaimed rewards? Check now.
Exactly. Exactly.
Thank you, Jeff, for that. And Rebecca, I know that you work on the Minecraft stuff business. You've got some Minecraft, a little bit of Minecraft news, right?
Yeah, I checked out the trailer for this earlier and I thought I would be remiss if I didn't mention it. So this actually came out last week, but it's up there in the marketplace. There's a free character creator skin. Just honestly, everything looks cuter in Minecraft, but The Incredibles, great movie. I think I might rewatch it soon after watching this trailer. But basically, yeah, they released a mashup. So the world, I think the name of the city is Municiburg, has been recreated in Minecraft, and you can go with the family and play on, play as one of these undercover superheroes. And there's a free character creator item. So that's within Minecraft, you could kind of customize your avatar with different items to wear, different personal features. And there is a super suit that you could wear in game, which is pretty cool. So more details on Minecraft.net. I highly recommend checking out the trailer. It's really cute. But yeah, it's available in the Minecraft marketplace.
I've not seen it. To your point, I haven't seen The Incredibles in a long time. So maybe I need to dust off my Disney Plus and check that out.
The second one, too. Mm-hmm. Was
thank you. Thank you. Thank you for bringing, thank you for
my second one.
Thank you for inviting us, Jeffrey. Okay. Wow. Lot of news, a lot of ways to redeem your points, win a console, check out cool stuff in Minecraft,
play games for free.
I mean, the list just goes, this is just the type of public service you get from this show. Just a reminder.
The only thing you don't get is your time back.
But, yeah, that's, know, but we, and, but we, good. We want to
do us at 1.5 speed.
All you have to,
1.25.
I may do that. I do that to a lot of podcasts. So
I do too.
So hopefully we sound just as good at 1.25 to 1.5 speed. But we're gonna talk about the next thing we're talking about is storage. Now, Rebecca, could you set us up for the interview? Because we've got Scott Weber's going to come by and talk about that.
Yeah, so our very own Larry Hryb, Xbox's Major Nelson, did an interview with Scott Weber for the Designed for Xbox team to learn about some of the new storage options. So let's take a listen.
Lots of new storage options for Xbox Series X and S owners. And joining us today is Scott Weber, who's the senior PM over there on the Xbox hardware team made for Xbox. Scott, welcome back to the show.
It's good to be back. Lots of exciting things happening as always.
Now, just let's refresh some folks that may not know this, but what does you and your team do?
Yeah, we're in the Design for Xbox program. So basically anything that is made for Xbox at Microsoft doesn't make themselves. We're guiding the end-to-end process, helping them with development, ensuring it meets a specific quality bar, and then help bring it to market, market it. We work with the marketing team and all sorts of other sides of Xbox to ensure that we have like great launches.
Like the podcast, and that's why you're here.
Yeah, exactly. We fill the gaps in the ecosystem is what we always say.
And one of the things recently we announced was Western Digital. There's now a Western Digital option for storage. And I've got my white gloves on because I always do when I handle your hardware. Western Digital is now a storage option. Up until now, we had Seagate as a storage partner for the storage for Xbox Series X and S. But now you have Western Digital, right?
Yeah, we're excited to bring them into the expansion card space. We've been working with WD for a number of years on HDD and SSD. And, we heard from the customers that they wanted more choice in this space. Yeah. And so we were excited to bring on WD, work with them really closely to bring a new expansion card into market. This is the C50. It's available now. And also at the lowest price points that we've ever been able to achieve, we actually were able to drop down with Seagate and WD together for this time and launch to make this more affordable than ever. We're really, really excited about it. We do listen. We know it's been a challenge in this space, and we're here.
And this, I want to point out that, we have 512, 1 terabyte and 2 terabyte options now. Is that available across both Western Digital and Seagate?
So WD is just doing 512 and 1 terabyte right now. And then Seagate has both of those as well as the 2 terabyte that's still available.
Yeah. Right. And those are available. You just kind of pop them back. And the beautiful part about it is because of the architecture that we have in the console, this type of storage is essentially this on the same spec as the storage, the onboard storage on the consoles, right, Scott?
Yeah, that's exactly it. And that's part of the convenience that you get with getting these cards is that you don't have to make sure it meets a minimum quality bar. You don't have to go through and see, all right, is this the heat sink that needs to go in here? Everything, it's all integrated and it matches one-to-one the performance. So when you're transferring games, you're playing games, you never have to worry about anything. You just plug it in and it's good to go. I mean, that's literally it. And it's been a really fun journey to now open this up to two different partnerships and have great options. WD obviously coming in with their own unique design language, and WD Black too, with the ridges and the really specific look that they have. It's just super, super cool product.
Yeah. And you're right, to your point, you know, we're seeing the kind of the promo video right now here, if you're watching this on Spotify or YouTube. And this is, you know, you talked about the design language, and it's exactly like the rest of the Western Digital Black line in terms of the ridges and the design. So it's something people know. Now, one thing I would like to point out is we've got the storage options, and these basically are hot swappable. You can just pull them in and out of the console that people may not know, right?
Yeah, I mean, I do it all the time, but I wouldn't say I'm a normal user. Right, you know, given likewise. I think I have three Xboxes upstairs in my house here.
Right.
But sometimes when you forget to download a game to all of your consoles, I'll just pull it out of here at the office and then just walk over to my bedroom, say I'm going to lay in bed and play this game while it transfers over. The transfer speed is so fast, really much, much faster than you'd get with anything else. It just moves over super quickly. So I use it all the time. Incredibly convenient. I've got all capacities and, yeah. You know, it's a wonderful product. I just love what we've done with it and love to get more choice here.
Well, your team does a lot of other things as well. You know, you talked about the Made for Xbox program. We've talked extensively on this show with your team. You've sent us over some demo, you know, some stuff to show off. One of the things I want to show off that we're excited about, in fact, I probably need to go full screen on me for this because his box is massive, is this little guy right here. And why don't you explain to us a little bit about this?
Our first ever wireless fight stick for Xbox. Really in more of a compact form factor, which is great. You know, we've been working with 8BitDo for a number of years now, a lot in the cloud gaming space, and then moved into controllers. And then, you know, this arcade stick, it's just so cool because the convenience to be able to take it wherever you go is awesome. I mean, if you're in the community, it's a very hardcore, passionate community.
Yep.
And a lot of these fight sticks that we've done in the past, like, they are hefty. We did one with Victrix. It's got a handle on it to, you know, take it from place to place. This is a little bit more compact, and then wireless or wired. Of course, you can always wire it in to make sure if you're concerned about latency or anything like that. Although we've tested it, and I personally can't tell the difference, although I'm not, you know, a diehard KI fan or something like that. You know, it's an amazing product. Yeah, let's talk to Ken about that.
But no, it's been a great product. I know Jeff and I were talking about it on the show a couple of weeks ago, and he's really looking forward to seeing this. And again, to your point, this is wired and wireless, but this is a great example of what your team does. You know, this little logo right down here, which you can kind of see if I zoom in or if my camera decides to behave, you know, is the Design for Xbox program. What does that program mean? I mean, I've had you on before to explain it, but do a high level refresher for folks that may not know what that means. They just see a sticker.
Yeah, it's an end-to-end process. You know, we have over 40 licensed partners now. We're in storage, obviously, niche products like fight sticks. We do flight sim hardware. We do wheel hardware. Also game pads, you know, high-end game pads, high-end audio, you know, affordable audio, just stands, mounts, like charging.
Controllers, of course.
Of course, we do absolutely everything. And so, you know, that process of joining the program is really understanding that someone understands what it means to build a product for the console. So there's a technical component to that. We have a wonderful engineering team that guides our partners from end to end, making sure that anytime they run into an issue in developing for the platform, they know how to get through that, and we're supporting them. Meanwhile, you know, we have obviously our brand requirements of those packages and making sure that everything meets our specifications and guidelines there. And it's really, really fun because we just get to ensure that everything that's used on the platform is of a really high quality bar. Our QA team, you know, tests these products extensively.
I've been into the lab. I wish I could show the lab. It's kind of crazy. It's like a Willy Wonka chocolate factory.
Yeah. You go through and you're, oh my gosh, picking out stuff to take home and try out is always really fun. But, you know, at the end of the day, our goal is to make sure that anytime you see that circular badge on a product, you know that it's been tested by Microsoft. You know that it's a great experience. It's going to work out of the box. You're not going to have to worry about, you know, dropouts or stuff not working or the battery life not being great. Like, we have battery life requirements. Wireless fight stick, you know, we've never had that before.
Right.
What's the battery life going to be like? it's 30 hours. That's incredible for the category, right? And so just making sure that, you know, we have this wonderful experience for everybody is really what we're all about.
Yeah. The other thing I want to point out is, like, because of, you know, gaming, as Phil Spencer, our ultimate boss, the CEO of gaming, you know, he talks about when everybody plays, we all win. You know, you also, you know, we talked about console, but Windows. Windows is also a really important part of it, because that's like the largest gaming platform in the world, right?
It is. And I would say, you know, testing from when I joined the team in 2014 versus where I am now has just dramatically changed. You know, it used to be we just test against console and that's it. Now, when we get a new product, and, you know, we have so many products that are also capable of connecting to Bluetooth to play cloud gaming on your mobile devices. Yeah. We have, you know, Windows 10 and 11. We test against those as well. Obviously, many of our audio products ship with a dongle or a base station that can connect to your PC and transmit over, you know, dual sources. Yep. We're testing every single one of those scenarios because it's Xbox everywhere now. It's not just your console, and that's what's super fun. And we're starting to see that in the portfolio of products that we're licensing to, is just making sure that we have something for everyone in any scenario.
You talked about your portfolio, and if you go to xbox.com, what is it, /? I think it's just made for Xbox. I could put the URL in the notes.
Yeah, there's an accessories tab sort of on xbox.com where we've got all of our stuff alongside the first party stuff.
You can actually do it in the console as well, too. When you're browsing the store, you can see a lot of the content in there as well, right?
Yep, definitely so. Like I said, you know, we're massive. And if you pal around a Best Buy, you see a lot of products with that badge on it, including some massive wheels that are just absolutely gigantic that you can take home and really go deep into the sim world.
Yeah. So anyway, we're back to storage. We're so thrilled that Western Digital is part of the program. These are available now. And I know that the prices have also come down quite a bit, haven't they?
They have, yeah. So we've come down to $150 for the 1 terabyte, $149.99. That's both Seagate and WD. That's our biggest price drop ever there. I think it gets us to a point where we're more in line with, you know, the rest of the industry right now, which is very volatile. Obviously, storage always is. And then the 512 gigabyte for WD is at $79.99. So that is a really, really affordable option. That's just been fantastic to bring.
Pop it in and get to go. Yeah, we like I say, go to xbox.com, the website, because that's where most of the content is. There's not much of it's kind of some of it's on the console, but you can go check out the web, or, you know, hit me up on Twitter as well. And Scotty, you're on Twitter as well, right?
I am. Yes. Scotty Weebs.
Scotty Weebs. I should have put that in the little graphic here, but I appreciate you coming on, Scott. And I know your team is always working on great partnerships and working with our partners on great products. So, you know, you're welcome to come back on again, whenever that is, whenever you have some more news to share. Any final words before I let you go?
I'll just say we've got a lot of cool stuff coming this year. And a lot of it's not announced, but, you know, we have Forza, we've got a flight sim update, everything that we saw in the game showcase, like, we've got products to support all of it and augment that experience to just be the best version of a gaming experience that you can do, especially when it comes to sim. You know, that's where we really listen to the community and hear the feedback. And it's just so fun to do this stuff, you know, and we've got a lot of cool things coming.
All right, Scotty, thank you so much. You're kind of the man when it comes to, and the legend when it comes to the Design for Xbox program. So we'll have you back on again soon, Scotty. Thanks so much for your time.
All right, great. Thanks.
Thanks, Scott. I'm actually using one of those Western Digital storage expansions. And I mean, it's working great. So it's nice to have options. It's nice to have choice.
It's good, nice job, to have Larry. Storage.
We always need more storage.
Anyway, thanks, Scott. And we'll have him on again. He's got, his team is always working on really interesting stuff. We talked about the 8-bit do. In fact, Jeff, I got to get this over to you. You're the one who asked me to get this.
Hey, what you doing for lunch, Larry?
Yeah, I know. We're going to reach up for that.
Fighter, that game begging for a fight stick.
But Scott and his team always work on cool stuff with our partners. So great to always have him on, and great to have storage options, as you said earlier. Hey,
let me buy you some chicken nuggies and we can trade.
Quick programming note. Next week, we may or may not have a show. We're still trying to figure out the schedule. And then the week after, we may or may not, because both Jeff and Rebecca are traveling. They've got some things going on. So if you don't find us, in your podcast feed, you can always find us on the socials, which I'm flashing up on the screen now. We've got a couple busy things going on. There's a holiday here in the US, July 4th. And then, like I said, Jeff, you and Rebecca are independently are traveling. Ironically, independently, you're traveling, but you're going to get together maybe somewhere else. I don't know. You guys are right, Jeff?
Yeah.
Yes. It will not be a work sanctioned event. It will
right.
just be hanging right. out and talking about stacking.
Not work. Not work.
Okay.
By the way, I just want to let you know, I want to, in full disclosure, I'm a little slightly embarrassed because I was hoping today to be able to share with you some of the salsa that I had from last week from that great recipe, but I was unable to get to it. So I apologize.
Oh, dang. You gotta send me a picture whenever you make it. Yeah.
Did I send you the recipe? I know I flashed it up. I don't know if I sent it to you.
You didn't, but I'm not going to lie. It sounds kind of complicated.
It is complicated. You know, it always, and that's the funny thing about, I have such an appreciation for people that love their craft and are really good at their craft. Like for instance, like a chef, this gentleman I spoke to was just good, but I don't have a $1 million kitchen and access and, you know, all these great, they have peppers down there in Mexico that we just don't have access to up here on a regular basis.
You just need a bowl and a spoon and a knife. I'm sure you can do it. I'm sure you can do it.
I appreciate your believing in me. Believe.
I have confidence in you too. Yeah. I wish I could try it.
Yeah. Well, maybe
podcast.
Maybe I'll wait until you both come up and have it. You know,
do we have a kitchen set where we could just do live?
No, we're not going to do the morning show kitchen thing. No, we're not going to do that with little aprons, little Xbox. Do we sell Xbox aprons over the gear store? Actually, I don't know.
I don't think so.
It could be.
I feel like I would have gotten one as a gift already.
I will ask about that. Anyway. All right. If you guys don't have anything else to share with us, I'm going to let you guys get back to your regular day jobs. Jeff, what are you looking up? I see your eyes darting across the screen madly over there.
No, I'm just thinking about the apron.
Okay.
You know, I want that.
I know.
My current mode is everything's an apron if you spill on it. You know, this could be an apron if I have a mishap at lunch.
A little bit of truth there. So anyway, make sure you, if you're on YouTube, like I mentioned at the top of the show, make sure you like and subscribe and do all the bell stuff. You know, that stuff that everybody in the world asks you. Everybody who asked you to do it, all your YouTube subscribers are stopped. They're selling VPNs. We're not doing that here. We're just giving you the news. Okay.
What if people want to hear you from a country that does not allow you?
Right? No, I'm saying that there's a time and a place for that, but you're not going to get that here. So that's all I'm saying. That's all I'm saying. So thank you, Jeff, for joining us. Rebecca, always great to see you. I'm a little bummed we heard Pumbaa, but we didn't get to see him today. Is he nearby?
No, he's feeling a little anxious after.
Yeah, I don't blame him. So it's been a tough week for everybody. Anyway, gang, I'll see you in a few weeks. Thanks again.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.